I'm going to talk a little bit about view camera bellows today. Obviously, if you're at all familiar with a view camera, there are only just a couple of parts. There's the film holder ground glass part on the back, and there's a lens on the front, and the bellows in between. They're flexible and allow you to focus the camera and make the view camera movements. The problem you run into is when they're no longer light tight. You can run into all sorts of problems with the film being fogged to, in some cases, I haven't had it happen to me, but I've seen examples of it. It'll actually form a second image on the film with the little hole, pinholes they're called, and you'll see why, acting as a second lens. So what I'm going to talk about is how to find the holes and how to repair them. And generally you'll see them in this area. It can be on either side, it can be top or bottom, but right in these folds it seems it's where the most movement is and there's the most stress. And as time goes on, the material starts to harden up. You can see that these are not in great shape. They're discolored, someone has folded them incorrectly, and they're just in need of repair or replacement. And actually these are going to be replaced at some point. I have patched them and I wouldn't hesitate to take the camera out and use it, but knowing that the bellows have problems, I would probably check it before I took it out. The easy way that I found to check it is get a small bright flashlight. This is an LED flashlight, and get inside of the bellows, and you could do it in a dark room. This flashlight's bright enough. You may even be able to see the hole if I can get the flashlight situated correctly. You can see there's a hole right there. You may not be able to see it, but once you identify it, you want to go up and down all the entire area. Take your time doing it. Some of the holes aren't apparent until you get both the flashlight and your eyes in the right place to see where the hole actually is. Once I identified where the hole is, I will take a pin and push it through the hole, and that does a couple of things. If you're doing it in a dark room, you can see where the hole is, but how are you going to find it when you turn the lights back on? I've spent a lot of time patching the adjacent fold to where the hole actually is without actually knowing where it is. There's a real possibility of doing that. The next step, and the material I'm using here is one that's recommended pretty widely on the internet, is a Permatex product, Ultra Black, High Temp, RTV. The difference between this and the other similar products that Permatex and other manufacturers make is this seems to have more pigment in it. And since we're sealing against light rather than air or water, more pigment is better in this case. And it's easy to find. You'll find it at an auto parts store. You probably won't find it at Walmart or one of those other places like that. But once you've identified where the hole is, you've got the pin in there, what you want to do is take some of this material, and you can put it on a stick or you can put it on your finger. Either way, it'll come off, it'll rub off. It's a little smelly. It smells like kind of like vinegar as it's curing. It cures in about 24 hours and then the smell is gone. But I'm going to get inside here, and on the pin, I'm going to put a little bit of the material. Make sure you get it on the pin, and then pull the pin through. And you're pulling the material, the silicone, off of the pin into the hole in the bellow, and then get in with your finger, maybe smooth it out a little bit, and then take what's left there and put it on the hole from the outside, so you've patched it from both sides. And that's a really good way to do that. It seems to really seal it up good, and it's black on black. It's not really apparent that you've done that, so it's cosmetically it's a pretty good repair. Another way of doing it is with a piece of electrical tape, and since the bellows are what were at one point one flat piece, if you put the tape on correctly, it will, even though it's flat, it will follow the folds in the bellows, and it will fold in there and it'll hold tight. That's probably the best quick way to patch leaky bellows, you could do that and use the camera now. There's no waiting 24 hours for the silicone to cure, and it's ugly, but other than that, it works perfectly well. And there are other materials that you can use in place of the silicone. I bought a kit from a place called Bostic and Sullivan, old time company that's been in business for years. Their patch material is in a liquid form, and they have a gauze that you put some of the liquid on. I do the same thing with the pin and pull it in. With the gauze material is that it gives a little bit of substance to the patch. You could probably use that on a larger hole. Another way of doing it is to actually, and you gotta have an old set of bellows to do this, most of you won't. I happen to have some. Cut a piece out of the corner of one of the bellows, and you can get fancy with it, and you can make it follow the contour of the hole, but actually put a new piece of bellows material over where the hole is, and you would coat it on the inside with the same silicone that we're using. You could do this from the inside, and I have done it before. It's hard to do because you're getting in there in some very small places, and the bellows do need to be able to fold again unless you want them permanently open. So they do need to be in the right place. And the inside of the bellows are coated with an anti-reflective material so that the light doesn't get bounced off and shining. And it makes it more difficult to glue the bellows material on there. The new bellows look something like this. These are the Chinese bellows that you can get for about $100. With a couple of days, a couple of hours work over a couple of days, you can put new bellows on the camera like this. But if you've got a $100 camera, you probably don't have $100 in a couple hours of labor that you want to put into it, unless it's a project that you want to do. They're not difficult to replace, but that's beyond the scope of what I'm really going to do today. They are available, $100 for 4x5 size. You can get them made for any camera, and they're about double that for an 8x10 camera, on up to anything that you want. If you get the bellows from the manufacturer, they're going to be much more expensive, but they do have the mounting plates, or in some cases they're wood. There's got to be some way to interface this with the camera. There's usually a metal plate that goes inside the folds and is glued in, and then screws go into that, or it's just glued on, or there's an industrial double stick tape that you can use. And that doesn't come in the cheap bellows. You got to cut the old bellows apart and take those pieces out, which isn't too difficult. On this camera, the plate is just like that. You would, and there's four screws in it. You unscrew it, screw it onto the front. The back of it, for some reason, does not come apart that easily on this camera. So it does have to be taped on, but there will be some metal reinforcement in there. The bellows from the camera manufacturer will have those parts in it. It'll be a little bit easier to put together, but not by a lot. But there are a couple of things you can do to keep the bellows in good condition. I've seen them up to 60 years old in my personal experience, leather Linhof bellows that were still in great shape. Higher quality material is part of it, and another part is taking care of it. The leather, you want to use something like Lexan as a special made preservative and conditioner for leather. For the plastics, you can use the synthetics, you can use other kinds of preservatives. I use Armor-All, not the Armor-All that you spray on, it's a different substance. It's a gel that goes on. It does not dry out. It is not real shiny like the Armor-All that you use on the dash in your car, though, even though that's what I use it for, is the dash in my car. It doesn't dry out. It's not the same stuff. It didn't turn brown, which the old Armor-All used to. I quit using it years ago, so I don't know if it still does. But you don't want to fold the bellows up, put the camera away when the bellows are dirty. You don't want to put them away when they're wet. And you want to make sure that all the controls on the camera are centered so you're not binding these bellows. You can see at some point these bellows have some crinkles in them. They were put together or put back, folded up with them not quite right. And once you bend them like that, it's pretty much forever. It may just be ugly, but to me it looks like a place for leaks to start happening. And it's avoidable. And any kind of damage like that that you can avoid in the long run, you're better off if you do. Well, that's about it for this time. I'll be back in future time and actually replace the bellows on one of these cameras and show you what's involved with doing that.